when I first moved here, you try so hard to fit in and end up feeling like you've given away a lot of yourself at the end.
So that's it? You're supposed to be stuck here and end up washed up like...
Like who?
I'm getting a tattoo!
All you have to do is sing. Sarah, would you like to go out?
I think you really enjoy this back and forth.
You think I'm turned on by bigoted fearmongers?
Will you marry me?
Place that you would have to be in to decide to inject something into your own heart is terrifying.
How do we know what the right thing to do is?
We don't. We'll figure it out.
Dear God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this food.
We can get our second chance.
Good evening. Even though we find ourselves here in January of 2021, we're here tonight to present to you the 2020 BFTV Screen Arts Awards. My name is Stephen Barden, and I am here with my partner in crime, Kathleen Cummins. Hello, Kathleen.
Hello, Stephen, and hello, everyone, BFTV students, faculty, and staff. Welcome.
And welcome to all of our family members that we hope are tuning in tonight as well, to acknowledge the finest in BFTV productions from the last academic year. To get us started, I'll turn it over to Kathleen to give us our traditional land acknowledgement. Kathleen?
Thank you. We would like to acknowledge that for thousands of years, this has been and still is the traditional territory of the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nations, Anishinaabe Nation, Huron-Wendat, and the Haudenosaunee Confederacy. Sheridan College sits on these lands, and it is our collective responsibility to honor and respect those who have gone before us, those who are here, and those who have yet to come. We are grateful for the opportunity to be working on this land.
All right, we'll dive right into our first award because that is what everyone is here to see and hear tonight. To present our first award of the evening, which is our First Year Best Short Award, please welcome our first-year faculty member, Kaya Sirala.
Year one is the first time everyone in their cohort meets and works together. This is the first time these students form crews and create their very first Sheridan productions. They bring their creativity to life.
The nominees for the Crimson Fish Award for First Year Best Short are...
So can we read your book?
Hitting It Off, Laura King.
Actually, I got a copy of the manuscript to my car. It's not proofread or anything. It's full of typos, if you're okay with that.
Yeah. I am the queen of typos.
Book?
Yeah.
My
Going bananas.
Bananas,
Eric Jenier. When We Were Kids, Christian Caniet.
Do you remember all that?
We were just kids back then.
And the winner for the best first year short is...
And now to present the Best Production Management Award, K. Carolyn Cox.
Production management is very important as it's their job to make sure everything is organized and ready to go. These production managers put in a lot of work that sometimes goes unseen. The nominations for Best Production Management are...
The nominees for the Crimson Fish Award for Best Production Management are... Anamnesis, Rosemary Daniels. Fever, Emma Lichty. Friendzone, Scott Morris, Samantha Yabut, Hannah Croyvin. The Humming Branch, Alyssa Frantangeli.
A didgeridoo, unless you're a certain type of player, you'll never be the front man. I like being that flow in the background. And it's one of those weird situations that whenever there's a group of people playing, if that person stops, you know that that person has stopped because...
And the winner for Best Production Management is...
Now we welcome one of our technologists to present the first year Most Outstanding Student Award. Please welcome Surrender Mention.
This award goes to a first year student who has achieved high academic standing by the end of their first year at Sheridan. Here is the award for a first year Most Outstanding Student.
And the winner is... And now John Neller, experimental filmmaker and faculty in BFTV, will be presenting the second year Most Outstanding Student Award.
This award goes to a second year student who has achieved high academic standing by the end of their second year at Sheridan. Here is the award for the second year Most Outstanding Student.
And the winner is... And now to present the award for Best Production Design, filmmaker and faculty member, Aisha Jamal.
Production design helps the audience immerse into a world that they are watching. Many people work very hard to get the sets to look exactly as they envisioned.
The nominees for the Sessler Award for Best Production Design are... Dagwoods Brigg, Alec Macri, Eric Artola.
As true as I've ever known.
I pieced together that map, mate. Those are my discoveries.
These coordinates that you give me, I'd better lead to an island.
Down Deloro River, Josh Wood.
Just focus on finding the chip.
Hijack.
The sooner we can hack
Joel Camilleri.
The sooner we can...
Hannah, I found something.
And the winner for Best Production Design is... And now to present the Screen Arts Award for Best Location Management, please welcome back Professor John Neller.
Location can determine the success of a film. It helps bring to life the world of the filmmaker's project. If a location is not found, or a crew does not have a good location management, it can ruin a film.
The nominees for the Best Location Management Award are Anamnesis, Down to Laurel River,
I love you,
Tattoo. Bye. And the winner for Best Location Management is And now to present the Television Award is Professor Randall Kapuscinski.
The Television Award is given to someone who shows the most enthusiasm and potential for television. The person who is presented with this award shows a true passion for television. Here is the Television Award.
For the Kojiko Television Award goes to... And the winner for the Television Award is...
Please welcome back Professor Randall Kapuscinski to present the Best Transmedia Award.
In today's age, media is more than just film and television. It transcends many mediums to include podcasts, virtual reality, books, games, and much more. Each year, our students are encouraged to expand their stories into these additional mediums.
The nominees for the Best Transmedia Award are... Agriculture, Bailey Regier.
It was like 8 o'clock in the morning. I was getting the kids out the door. My phone was on silent, so I had missed 2 phone calls from TJ. And the third one, I had my phone, so I answered it, and it was him.
Animal Calling, Candace Dixon, Olivia Chafe, and Samantha Yabut.
There are some people that compassion fatigue has taken over their capacity to feel empathy towards people or the animals anymore.
Hey.
Hi, Jack. Asad Chowdhury.
You can't just reboot and install new software to avoid a conversation. I couldn't have a tool to fight Cinder. No, no. I had to be paired with a childish, 7-foot-tall plug-in comedian.
And the winner... for the Best Transmedia Award is...
And now to present the Best Visual Effects Award is Shivani Sondi, faculty member and visual effects artist.
As the students in our BFTV program advance their skills throughout the years, their films become increasingly complex. Many creative minds imagine stories of fireball explosions, extreme weather, ghosts, and futuristic technologies. All of this could not be possible without the technical skills of our VFX students.
The nominees for the Best Visual Effects Award are Haman Oculus, Christopher Barecki. Natural, Miguel Fernandez.
It didn't work?
Spelled.
Why didn't
Miguel
it work?
Fernandez.
You said this would work on advanced witchcraft.
This potion is purchased with any magic that reacts with the body.
Great. So I'm gonna stay like this forever? Forget about being on the council. I'll be the laughingstock of our community.
No, Morgan is not going to get away with this.
And the winner for best visual effects is...
She teaches in some of our senior critical writing classes, so to present the Best Critical Writing Award, please welcome back faculty member Aisha Jamal.
The time and effort put into researching a topic and forming an opinion are invaluable to education and personal advancement. Here are the nominations for Best Critical Writing.
The nominees for the Best Critical Writing Award are Stephanie Rothman, New Hollywood Feminist, Haley Solakis. Tolerating Individuality in Beyond the Hills, Monica Meng. Leaves in Iron, An Analysis of Fantasy Genre in Princess Mononoke and Lord of the Rings, Sebastian Blokowski. Andrei Tarkovsky, A True Artist, Tommy Garreau.
And the winner of the Best Critical Writing Award is...
And welcome back to Kaya Sarala to present the Best Original Score Award.
The music complements a film. It can emphasize emotion, support a theme, and elevate a character.
The nominees for the Screen Composers Guild Award for Best Original Score are Anamnesis, Mark Edwards.
Did a DNA test and it came
on
out
the
with
fence,
the expected results.
Naomi Hernandez.
You are who you are. You're Irish and Scottish. This is you. It's in your blood.
I am something and I am who I am and who I've become, and that's fine. There's no right way of living, and I know that I'm trying the best that I can. Just keep going.
The Hillside Perspective, Steve Grable.
And the winner for Best Original Score is...
Okay, listen up. To present the Best Sound Award, faculty member Elinor Svoboda.
Making and watching films helps us understand the importance of excellent sound. The ultimate goal is for the sound to be seamlessly integrated with the visuals on screen. Here are the nominations for Best Sound, okay?
The nominees for the Sound Dogs Award for Best Sound are Anamnesis, Austin McDonald, and Rachel right. Zarafa.
And do you want to try?
I'll do this one.
And do you want to flip a page for me?
Sure.
Down to Laurel River, Fiona Alvarez and Maggie Hammond. Fever, Jesse Conan.
What Comes Next, Tyler Fernandez and Blake Russell.
Give me your riches, give me your loving, get me inspired, New York be...
And the winner of the Best Sound Award is... Staying in the world of post-production to present our Best Editing Award, Professor Victoria McGlynn.
For many, a film story is made within the edit suite. A combination of writing and technical skills, editing requires a broad range of skill set.
The nominees for the Best Editing Award are Anamnesis, Lexi Troth. Down Deloro River, Josh Wood.
Sable! Help me! Sable! Help me! Help me! Sable! Help me!
Tattoo, Tommy Garreau.
Act like your life is over because you took a year off of school.
Go get your shit.
And the winner of the Best Editing Award is...
And now to present the Most Outstanding Female Graduate Award, Maureen Judge, documentary filmmaker and professor.
Historically, the film and television industry has been imbalanced between the genders. Today, Sheridan is helping to shift that imbalance by accepting more female students and recognizing their talents. It gives me great pleasure to present the award for Outstanding Female Graduate.
The WIFT Award for Outstanding Female Graduate goes to...
And the winner is... I love his hairstyle, and I love him presenting the award for Best Screenplay. Please welcome faculty member Bill Robertson.
The story is the single most important component of a film. The strength of a great screenplay has a direct effect on the strength of the final product.
The nominees for the Meridian Artists Award for Best Screenplay are... Across the Aisle, Nathan Isings and Matthew C. Wainwright.
Some of us are given our talking points every day, and if we don't stick to the fucking script, we'll never work in another fucking newsroom again. So yeah, I did it.
Exactly.
So,
The Hillside Perspective.
What are your plans for
Steve
Christmas?
Steve Grable.
We're gonna go see Kyle's parents.
Oh, okay.
Is that okay?
Yeah. I didn't have any plans anyways.
To destroy humanity.
Judgment Day. Joel
Werenich. I'm dating your daughter as part of an elaborate scheme to bring death and ruination to the planet.
Is that sarcasm? Can you things even do sarcasm?
No, no! I'm just talking like this because my robot voice box is glitching out.
I can't tell!
Anything else you'd rather have for your birthday?
Tattoo. James Ferguson.
I'm against me getting a tattoo.
Because I think they're so tacky, sweetheart.
Well, I don't care what you think. It's my body.
Why don't you just wait until you've moved out, got your own apartment, and your own job?
What if that never happens?
And the winner of the Best Screenplay Award is...
And welcoming back Carolyn Cox, professor in camera and lighting
to present the Best Cinematography Award.
Whether we realize it or not, everything we see on screen and the way we see it is done for a reason. A skilled cinematographer chooses the best light, angle, composition, and movement to tell the story through images.
The nominees for the Richard Leiderman Award for Best Cinematography are...
Family stuff going on, like...
Agriculture, Jade McKenna.
It's like anybody that even owns their own business in the city, like, unfortunately, if you own the business, it's on you to kind of take the sacrifice, right?
As much as it has some tie down sometimes, it is still nice to have the freedom and to be able to take my son.
Down to Laurel River, Steve Bagshaw.
Yeah, I fell on a sharp rock in the river.
So where's Sable?
He couldn't make it. He stayed back to do some more prospecting.
Well, that's odd. He usually doesn't miss a chance to visit. He never misses a meeting.
Freebird, Tony Truong.
Why won't you start?
And the winner for Best Cinematography is...
And now to present the award for Best Directing, please welcome faculty member Robert Dulesky.
Directing is not only about having a creative vision. It's about sharing that vision with a team in order to bring it to life. The best directors are the ones who can communicate and collaborate with their colleagues in order to create something that they never could have accomplished on their own.
The nominees for the Best Direction Award are...
I have my hobbies.
Down to Laurel River, Josh Wood.
So what that gold? You keep your trading off the books?
Yeah, but I should let you know there is a charge.
Yeah, I figured. How much of a cut you take?
It's not like that.
What do you mean?
Myths We Live By, Emily Ryder.
Is she?
Of course she is. She's a psycho.
Tattoo, James Ferguson.
You weren't really being specific with what you want to do.
I've got a lot on my plate, Chris. I just wanted to drive around.
And I just wanted to hang out. But you're being real childish right now.
I'm sorry that I'm just not feeling it today.
You haven't been feeling it since college started for everyone.
And the winner of the Best Directing Award is...
And now to present... The third year Most Outstanding Student Award is Professor Catherine Tamas.
Hey everyone, really great to be with you. Well, many BFTV students will agree that third year is an absolute doozy. It's pretty challenging. Students are asked to complete three separate film projects in a single year with full crews, full cast, off-campus locations, of course that's pre-COVID, and little money. Well, here is the award for most outstanding student in third year.
And the winner is... And now to present the Most Outstanding Graduate Award, please welcome back faculty member Eleanor Svoboda.
This is the award for Most Outstanding Graduate. This year marks the third cohort of graduates for our Bachelor of Film and Television program. It is clear that each and every one of our graduates with us today is all outstanding in their own right. It is not easy being the guinea pigs for a program that is only a few years old. Today, we would like to celebrate one of those outstanding graduates. Here is the award for Most Outstanding Graduate.
The Most Outstanding Graduate Award goes to...
The winner is... And now to present the Best Nonfiction Award is Professor Wendy Donnan.
Documentaries are informative, visually stunning, and groundbreaking. They appeal to us because of their unique and real-life stories.
The nominees for the VisTech Award for Best Nonfiction Production are...
It's the reason people...
541, A Place for Community, Scott Morris.
It's the reason for 541... Cooking for me has no meaning if I'm just cooking for myself.
You couldn't manage to go to school.
Blood Baby, Hannah Kroyven.
Screaming for me not to leave you. The truth was that at the most horrible time in your young life and mine, you were held hostage to this diagnosis and would beg me not to let people hurt you.
I just want to pack up and go back to Pakistan.
On the Fence, Asad Chowdhury and Aura Torres.
Fundamental of my like life and existence is like just stripped away for like maybe that like 10 minutes or something, just because it's like, well, if this isn't your home, then where do I belong? Like, where do I go?
It's hard for me to think of any one place as a home.
And the winner for the Best Nonfiction Film Award is... Vladimir Kabelik is a documentary filmmaker and a former professor from Sheridan. Vlad has had a major role in documentary filmmaking in Canada. His films explore and transform Canadian social realities. This year's award goes to a BFTV student who demonstrated innovation, creativity, and excellence in the documentary form. And the winner is...
And now for our final award of the evening. To present the nominees for the Best Narrative Award, please welcome Professor David Barlow.
Nominations for Best Narrative Film have one or two names attached, the producers. But we all know that the producers, hardworking souls that they are merely the representatives of the entire teams that brought these films to fruition. Filmmaking in BFTV is a team effort, and never was that more true than in this past season. So congratulations to all the teams that managed to complete a narrative project in the spring of this year.
The nominees for the SIM Award for Best Narrative Production are...
Where have you been?
The Hillside Perspective.
For the last 7 years.
Autumn Mosey.
Could I choose between my son and my husband?
But you did choose. And now that Dad's dead, you suddenly decide to care?
Well, maybe we could work out some
Judgment
sort of
Day.
Custody situation.
Joel Laringe and Ander Bareilles.
I want you to be there for all of that.
Why? Why is that so important?
Because I love you!
You do?
Yeah.
What comes next? Juliana Corso.
New York. Oh, baby. I've heard stories. I heard that you play rough and you've got game.
And the winner of the 2020 Screen Arts Award for Best Narrative is... Well, this isn't how we normally like to present this show, but that doesn't diminish or take away from the quality of the work of all of our nominees and winners tonight. Congratulations once again. We look forward to being able to see you again in person sometime very soon.
Thanks for tuning in. Thanks to our sponsors. And thanks to all the students, the faculty, the staff, the technologists who made this year absolutely fantastic. Thanks again.
Good night.
Good night.